Okay, this is Winter Gardening in Texas, Part 2. Today is March 10th, 2014. And I'm just going to go around and show you the things that I am doing. And kind of follow the same path that I did with my first video. Okay, so this is, you know, if you compare this to the first one, the garlic is fine. That's going to come along and be all right. Yeah, we might get some parsnips. We might get some parsnips, it looks like. A few. And there's some carrots over there. But this has really been an extraordinary winter, as you all know. Just a week ago, we had temperatures down to 16 again, and wow, I mean, last year, I mean, it maybe got down to freezing twice, but we've had, you know, numerous weeks of temperatures in the 20s and down to the teens. The coldest it got down to that I saw was 12. Now, over off to the side here, this is it's just laying in a pile now. But this is my insulative covering that I had on it at first through the coldest weather. And actually, these things survived pretty well. But, I mean, they didn't grow, but they survived. So there's parsnips, radishes, beets, rutabagas, carrots. Okay, so last week, though, I don't know if you can tell. Yeah, you can probably see this. Okay, I had to put bird netting up because our chickens are free range. I think I'm going to lock them up tonight because one got in the dog yard yesterday and lost its life. Okay, but anyway, so the chickens were getting into my garden and digging everything up. So I had this netting over it already. So I put the insulated cover over the top of everything, and it sort of saved the carrots and the parsnips, you know, the radishes that looked pretty good, just completely, you know, these are radishes. They were big and full and wonderful, and I had even eaten a few, and the beets were looking pretty good, and they're gone. Anyway, I don't think I'm going to do this again next year. In fact, I have ordered through the mail. I did plant some blackberries. They're just sticks right now, but they're alive. I planted some blackberries in the fall, last fall, and I've ordered some more blackberries, and I'm going to try some raspberries and dewberries and grapes, and just see if we can get some fruit like that going. This is irrigated from our washing machine, and then the sink, tub, and shower in the master bedroom. The water comes down. It's an L-shaped garden. And I don't know. I mean, of course, I think gray water, you know, they recommend that more for trees and things anyway. But I did have a few years of getting some things. But anyway, this was the garlic, yes. You know, that ought to grow and produce and be fine. Okay, so coming to the greenhouse. Now, the temperature is over 80 degrees, so we have this window that opens automatically when it gets too warm. I have a little sad-looking patch of onions. Of course, the chickens completely dug all these up before I covered them. I think they'll come back, though. They look better than they did. Okay, coming. Let's get a shot of the greenhouse kind of from a distance. Greenhouse. And remember, this is the design by Texas Prepper 2. And I really like it. In my other video, I gave an incorrect account of the dimensions. It's 7 foot wide and 16 feet long. And you know what? This is the main thing that I want to... This is one of my main efforts here, is that, you see, I want good tomatoes. I want tomatoes that are big, plump, and juicy. And these are some I started by seed right here. And these over here are ones that I actually bought as plants in the first video. They're little tiny plants, but they're blooming all over, and the ones I started from seed here are getting ready to bloom. I have some Russian kale down there and some bachelor buttons, a few flowers, and that's a Hubbard squash in there. Am I getting that? Yeah, Hubbard squash. Okay, and then I have, these guys got nipped by this last, I mean, we had, okay, so I have propane heater, kerosene heater, electric heater, sun lamps, okay. And we heated this thing during the cold weather, but it still nipped these tomatoes that I have just in the containers in the back here. Okay, but I'm looking up here. Okay, so Steve redesigned our aquaponics. If you looked at the first video, you can see that we originally had them vertical. But several weeks ago, nothing grew. Also, I don't think we had enough fish. But anyway, the plants that are in there right now, they're Swiss chard. I started by seed, and then some... Okay, so the idea with the cucumbers is that they'll hang down rather than having them climb something. Okay, down here are ground cherries and pepper plants. And they were very tiny when I had transplanted them. These I started in these thin... I won't use these again. I just didn't have very good luck. These are supposed to be leeks and some onions, and there's some of that vine that's in the over in there in the aquaponics. But these guys survived, and I got them in bigger pots, but I'm gonna have to split them again. But I love ground cherries, so I'm gonna have, and these peppers, you know, we'll give them each their own pot. And these are just a few more cabbage and broccoli that I just got at the feed store as plants. So anyway, stepping back, greenhouse, yeah. So I really hope to have big juicy tomatoes and green beans and cucumbers and eggplant and some herbs out of this. That's, well, and the Swiss chard over there too, and some broccoli. My kids like broccoli. It's amazing. But, okay. Okay. Trying this again. Okay. So coming around, this is the bottom half of the L. And, okay, so I threw these leaves on top of here when it was getting cold. I planted a couple of fig trees here, and I'm planning to plant a couple hazelnut trees in here, but I have potatoes underneath all of this that I planted, and they're growing. Hopefully they'll pop through the leaves all right. But once again, I had some cabbage that I had been covering, and it looks like it's all gone now. I mean, the leaves just weren't enough to shield it from that cold weather. I've got the netting here as well because of my chickens. Over here, I had shown you my... Okay, the strawberries are still surviving, but the cabbages took a hit. And see, these guys actually were big and beautiful before a week ago, and I covered them. I had like two layers of the insulated cloth and a blanket on top of them. But that was, you know, we had the wind chills of minus 10, and I guess it just wasn't enough. I'm still hoping I might get a head of cabbage out of that. I don't know, it looks pretty terrible. And of course, my rosemary really got nipped. I'll have to trim that all back. So down there, my sage plant is surviving, and I have a little thyme plant in there that's making it. Now, coming over here, okay, so this is where I had my tomatoes planted. But of course, you know, I pulled them all out. And, you know, this is the dirt that I've been using from these beds here. You know, they're layered, make-your-own dirt kind of a thing. And that's what I've been using in my greenhouse to plant everything. And it's just been really wonderful. I'm coming over here. Okay, so I don't have any netting, but see, I had purchased some at the feed store, a few spinach plants, and my chickens got in here, but this seems to be keeping them off. Hopefully it doesn't make it too hot for the spinach. Yeah. Okay, so, and once again, this is, you know, this is where I had my peppers, and this is just beautiful dirt. Now, you know, it was a cotton burr and cardboard, mostly. A little bit of manure, a little bit of rotten bark, but mostly, mostly in these beds, I layered cotton burr and cardboard. And then we took, we dug some kind of nice dirt out of our creek bed to use on the top. Now, I put my name in to get the load of cotton burr again, but I must have been too far down on the list. But what I did was I put my a little request on a local radio show called Talk Time to see if someone had leaves. And so this guy calls me up and had 50 bags of leaves. So that's what I'm going to use now to rebuild my beds instead of the cotton burr. And here's another little thing I'm trying. There's potatoes under there. Now I'm going to be putting some more stuff on here, probably some chicken manure and some dirt and sand and maybe a little bit. But what you do is, you know, you put down a layer of. Now I'm using cardboard. The video that I watched to learn how to do this on YouTube, they used newspaper, and they didn't use leaves, they used straw. But a friend of mine, her grandfather in Oklahoma, used to grow potatoes. So there's potatoes under there. There's cardboard, lay down the potatoes, and then you just stack a whole bunch of leaves and stuff on them. I'm going to kind of bury it and let it compost and grow. And supposed to be no-dig potatoes. Okay, one more thing. Okay. Yes, yes, the hose was on and dripping. So, okay, so I had, these were my potato barrels that I had. They were in the greenhouse, and the potatoes grew tall way up above, and I was using leaves and straw and mulchy stuff to pack in around them. Well, as it turns out, I ended up getting, okay, I had dirt in the bottom. Well, that's the only place where the potatoes grew instead of the theoretical, you know, potatoes growing up all the way through it. And I think you can see some leaves in there. I'm still going to use leaves because my dirt is just too hard, but I'm going to use this pile of dirt here, alternating with the leaves, and so I'm trying potatoes one more time. I mean, we got enough for a couple of meals. They tasted really great, but it didn't yield 50 pounds like the person on the YouTube video. However, you know, she used dirt. So that must be a factor, I guess. So, okay, well, that's about it for now.